बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम पीएच मेजरमेंट लेक्चर नंबर 3। दिस इज माय थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन फिजिको केमिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ बायोकेमिस्ट्री। पीएच इज डिटरमिंड बाय इंडिकेटर कलरीमेट्रिक मेथड एंड बाय इलेक्ट्रॉनिक पीएच मीटर। इंडिकेटर एंड कलरीमेट्रिक मेथड दे आर चीप but they are not accurate. Colorimetric method, it is the most common analytical technique used in biochemical estimation in clinical laboratory. It involves quantitative estimation of color, but it also involves our visual sight, that how much fast or low, not accurate, but quantitative estimation of color. A substance to be estimated colorimetrically must be colored, or it should be capable of forming chromogen. So this color, it form color, and according to this color complex, dark or some blue, red, and these, through the addition of the reagent, its color on the addition of reagent is other, and before it is and other color. So it is very cheap, no complicated instruments are, electronic instruments are required. It is easy, cheap method to estimate pH. Now there is another method, indicator. Acid turn blue, litmus paper red, alkaline turn red, litmus paper blue. So there it used indicator. Indicators are, they produce, indicator produce hydrogen ion, and before in there they have one color in undissociated form, and dissociated form they have other color. So when the concentration of acid or base is equal, the color will be in between blue, red and purple. In the litmus paper is reacted with different indicators. So what is indicator? A substance which change color depending on whether the solution tested is acidic or alkaline. So at each degree of dissociation there will be different shades of the color, and by this method, by using indicator, a color is developed that is composed with standard scale color. For example, it is dissociated, undissociated indicator gave rise hydrogen ion and indicator, which is different in color. They are usually solution can come from natural sources or synthetic sources. For example, phenolphthalein, red orange, and methyl orange, etc. Congo red. Each indicator has definite pH range over which it is completely dissociated or undissociated. Decreasing or increasing the pH beyond the range will not have any further effect. For example, Congo red has a pH range 3 to 5. It is yellow at pH 3 or less, and red when the pH is 5 or more. Phenolphthalein has a pH range 8.3 to 10. It is colorless at pH 8.3 or less, and red at pH 10 or more. Benefit of this system, it is very cheap. No instruments are required. Drawbacks, it is not accurate system of measurement. Not accurately applied for already colored solution. Methyl orange has a pH range 3 to 14. It is orange to red, and at pH 4 to 14, it is orange to yellow. Phenolphthalein has remained colorless pH 1 to 9 and 10 to 14 colorless to pink. A pH meter, it is an electronic pH meter, is an electronic instrument used for measuring the pH of a liquid. Through special probes, are sometimes used to measure the pH of semi-solid substance. A typical pH meter consists of special measuring probe called the glass electrode and a reference electrode. So it consists of two electrodes, glass electrode and reference electrode, connected to an electronic meter that measure and display the pH reading. A pH meter consists of two electrodes, a measuring electrode and a reference electrode. Measuring electrode has a tip at the bottom of this electrode, which has a membrane to which hydrogen ions are penetrated, and through which, when the solution contains the hydrogen ion, so it comes in contact with the measuring electrode. It consists of the silver rod, and with the solution of the silver chloride paste, immersed in the silver chloride paste, and to this it is solvated by the standard HCl solution. While the reference electrode consists of a copper or mercurous chloride paste and merged in and has saturated potassium chloride solution. So it is sensitive to the hydrogen ion. So when they come in contact, there is a potential difference created, and which is measured by a potentiometer and then converted into the electric current. So here is the measurement of the pH meter. So this is the measuring electrode, and this one is the reference electrode. It is connected with a potentiometer and then the electric signal meter. And so this meter, it is having a membrane consists of mercury, silver and silver chloride paste electrode, and it is with the HCl solution. And then there is a known hydrogen potential difference is produced, which is reference of the reference electrode is measured into the potentiometer and then converted into the electric signal. If the solution contains the equal amount of hydrogen and hydroxyl ion, there will be no potential difference will be produced, and it will be pH will be the same. To measure the pH sensor is immersed in the test solution. The hydrogen ions are able to penetrate the boundary areas of the glass membrane, which is called gel layer, and results in charge separation. The same process occurs inside the center sensor with normal solution buffered at pH 7 that has constant concentration of hydrogen ion. If the hydrogen ion concentration, hence the pH value on inside difference from the concentration on outside, then measurable potential difference form. So what is the फायदा क्या है पीएच मीटर का, कि हम कलर्ड कंपाउंड का भी पीएच हम मेजर कर सकते हैं, जबकि कलरीमेट्रिक मेथड में और इंडिकेटर में हम नहीं कर सकते. थैंक यू वेरी मच.